up? Chris Mosley here, man. I'm over in Atlanta, Georgia. I came over here because my daughter had some swimming lessons over here in the morning, so I definitely wanted to be there to film and document that special day of her taking her first swimming lessons. And she'll be taking them throughout the whole summer, man. So basically, I'm going to give you guys some little cinematic clips of her starting her first swimming lesson, which is going to be epic for me, man. It's just legendary to even be a part of that, to be able to document that, man. Y'all stay tuned. Back to the house. My daughter and her cousin had their swimming lessons. Yeah, we went and got some food from Chipotle, and now I'm just straight up exhausted. So I'm gonna try to get a nap real quick. Hopefully I capture some real little cinematic footage for y'all to check out, man. That was on the GH4 with the 35mm 1.4 and the 24-105 f4, and both of those are Canon lenses that I used an adapter. Just a cheap adapter to put them on the GH4. Not even the one that gives you electronic control for the autofocus and control of the aperture. So basically, I'm using an adapter that allows me to use my Canon lenses, but only wide open at whatever the aperture is. Like my F4 lens, I'm not able to stop that down. Like my Canon 35mm 1.4, I'm not able to stop that down. And that's what I'm using now. So that's why the depth of field is so shallow, because I'm not able to stop these lenses down right now because of the adapter I'm using. So I'm slowly starting to realize I'm going to have to go ahead and drop that $600 on the Metabone Speed Booster, because that's going to be so helpful to be able to stop these lenses down and get better footage for real, man. But hey, that's about all I got going on right now. Just getting used to this GH4, because it is a totally different world. But I think it's very rewarding when you know how to use the camera, but it's just like a learning curve. With the Canon 6D, I was able to just pull it out and shoot in any lighting condition. But with this one, you'll get some grain and some noise even at ISO 800. So you got to be careful where you film at and use your light wisely. But in the long run, I feel like this camera is going to make me a better videographer. Have better control of my light and just have better composition of the shots, man, for real. Another thing is, when I use the 96 frames per second, slow motion, it's kind of choppy. Yeah, the footage is still usable, but at that 96 frames per second frame rate, the lighting looks very choppy, especially under like fluorescent lighting or LED lighting. It's just like a flicker. I don't know, you know, what the deal is with that. I'm gonna keep testing this camera and everything, but just a heads up on anyone interested in purchasing it. At 96 frames per second, I get a chopping effect. So that's just a heads up.